My name is Stephen McGann, and my book is called Flesh and Blood. It's a history of my family in seven maladies, seven diseases that affected them over the last 150 years and molded the kind of people that we believe ourselves to be. In chapter two, it has the title Pestilence, because we found my family in 1871 in an absolutely desperate slum in the north end of Liverpool, in dire poverty, and in conditions so conducive to the spreading of infectious disease that the city of Liverpool needed to do something as an emergency measure to try and cope with the problems of these kind of appalling afflictions. One of them was smallpox. And for me, the journey begins with a death certificate. In 1871, one of my own relatives, little Sarah, died of variola, smallpox. We don't know the disease nowadays. It's been eradicated from the wild, from the world, although it still exists in a few labs. But I go back in time to a time when it was everybody's problem. But more than that, I talk about the people these poor people were who lived in this Irish ghetto, and the way the rest of the population saw them, the way their attitudes were molded by the diseases they had, and the way, in a sense, these poor peasant people became indistinguishable from the terrible pestilences they carried. If you like, they became a pestilent population. At the end of my chapter, I discuss one of the dangerous results of thinking that a group of people can be indistinguishable from an infectious disease or a pestilence. And I discuss my personal experience in the Hillsborough football disaster, and how the terrible miscarriage of justice that sustained for 27 years was, I believe, partly because the people that the nation was talking about, they commonly believed to be a pestilent tribe and not simply a group of people who went through a terrible tragedy.